Right back here on the show. Johnny, I think this is more your style.
You know, Martin, I feel at home.
Right?
Reminds me of the days of Two for the Road. And of course, oh no, it's Johnny and June Kittley.
Yes.
Late hour with June and Johnny.
That's it. The late hour with June and Johnny.
My gosh.
In the social media, does Johnny post? Actually, you do. Like once every 3 years, it looks like you post.
Oh my gosh.
Tell me about this. What is this all about?
We decided to invite the original team.
Reunion.
Of Oh No, It's Johnny for a reunion.
Mm-hmm. It was a Oh No, It's Johnny reunion. Now, Maurice Akache was like your Ed McMahon, right?
Correct.
Like your fall guy, right?
Well.
What was that like? Because I know this guy has a mouth too. Maurice says it the way it is.
I created a segment for him called Arcachat.
Arcachat.
Where he taught social manners. How to pack, that's with a P, not an F.
So,
how to pack.
Maurice is a mother packer.
Yes.
He's a mother packer.
Mother packer.
He's a mother packer.
You're naughty.
You're naughtier.
Me?
You started it.
I am as
You invented naughty.
I am as harmless as a Jesuit priest.
On your last birthday, which I missed, I'm so sorry, you were overpopulated, I heard. How does that happen? Is this a scene that you posted from your birthday?
Oh yes, yes.
Look closely now. That's a stand-up cutout of Johnny Litton.
We invited 600 people, 800 arrived.
What? You didn't even have a table, I heard.
I lost my seat because somebody, how did you know this?
I know this.
You're fantastic.
No, Tabitha's fantastic. Stop it. Back here, back to me.
Oh,
no, I know, later.
I have a weakness for women as brilliant and as tall as Gloria Macapagal. Oh, you have some.
What is this?
My goodness.
The apple doesn't fall far from the tree.
These were gifts from my Chinese friends.
Chinese New Year?
Yes. This is supposed to be good fortune.
Good fortune. He posted this in 2015. It's so old.
I'm so surprised you have that.
Yeah.
Where'd you get this?
And it's cardboard too.
My God.
Who is this?
That was me when I was younger.
How about this?
Aoki is a Japanese DJ.
Very well known DJ.
Very well known.
What is your preference of music though? Do you like that kind of?
I'm old fashioned.
So what's your music?
Like for example, Breakfast at Tiffany's,
mm.
Moon River. I
Moon
love that.
River. Who's Huckleberry, though?
Wider than a mile.
I don't get the words, though.
I'm crossing you in style someday.
Has anyone ever had the balls to tell you, Johnny, you're talking too much?
My mother-in-law.
Oh, she has the license, too.
Yeah.
Not just the balls.
She's a very good driver. She drives me crazy. She drives me up the wall, but she's a good driver. Hello.
Has your routine changed much in life? I mean, are you as busy as you were during the Oh No, It's Johnny days? Is that your schedule? You still write it? Oh my Lord. Look at that. He puts his whole calendar right here in his pocket. This too, you have it all the way till March. You're all set. December to, you can throw this one away just so you know. It's December.
December.
My God, I can't even read what you wrote.
Okay.
So you find yourself having to write things down?
Yes, because I erase sometimes the changes and things like that.
That's unbelievable.
You know,
and he carries it in his pocket.
You don't have time to get old when you're busy. And it's no longer a job when you love what you're doing.
Do you love what you're doing?
Yes.
Now, what's the best thing about having a big family as opposed to one or two children?
Do you know when you get old, one of the many things you look for is really someone to talk to share, and let's say you travel. Have you ever pictured yourself, Martin, traveling alone? Jesus, it's so lonely.
It's lonely, yeah.
And then eating alone. And then also, when you exchange views, you get educated. I learned a lot of geography because my parents used to travel a lot. And then, why is it, it's called, you know, Pavlov, the conditioned reflex.
Mm.
Okay. I'm going to Rome. Then before you know it, everybody's going to Rome.
Mm.
But, you know, there are other countries.
Mm-hmm.
There's so much of this world to see.
And you want to see that with your family.
Yes.
You want to share that experience with them. Do you have the rule for your family? Is there one basic Johnny Litton rule?
Yes. Number one, Papa is always right. Number two, if you have a doubt, see rule number one.
Do you still have your Sunday dinners and get together? Is that still mandatory?
I have five sons. They own Monday to Saturday. Sunday is mine. You have to have dinner. No cell phones on the table.
Oh, wow.
Conversation is required.
Wow. Now, why do you think that's important? Why do you think it's important not
because
to have any
distractions? Because we exchange ideas.
Distractions.
And my shoulder, my room is always open to you when you have a problem. No drugs. No drugs. No politics. No religion in the dining table.
Of all the things that happened in your life, what is the one thing that you're most grateful for?
Wow. That I have a wife that tolerates me, my faults, my many mistakes. If I were married to me, I would have separated years ago. Okay, and I mean that de corazón, from the heart.
Okay, so you have
I have a woman that I would consider the nearest thing to a saint. She loves me in spite of who I am and what I've done to her. Love is the key to all.
True, very true. That's one thing I've learned about Johnny through the years, not just in this interview, is that if the, of all the facade that you show us, the from outside looking in, we see a person who's all full of fun, games, jokes, punchlines, pickup lines, but deep down inside is a spiritual man who really wants to make a difference in this world. Long story short, if he could do it over again, he would do it the same way he's been doing it from the very beginning of time. And many times more. Johnny, thank you so much for being on the show.